Alright guys, today I'm gonna make an Atlas stone with an IKEA mold.
Did you know that IKEA is selling an almost perfect Atlas stone mold? You do now. The Atlas stone is often used by strongmen in their daily training and in competitions. An Atlas stone is made of concrete and is usually a perfectly round shape. I've seen a lot of DIYs of people making their own stone mold. And usually they end up with a not so round Atlas stone. So for many years I've actually been looking for a cheap and good solution for Atlas stone mold. Buying the molds themselves is quite expensive, so I've been looking for something that could be used as an alternative. And as it turns out, IKEA is actually selling something that I think would be really good for Atlas stone. Here's a steel ball from IKEA, from their Blanka series. It's 28 centimeters in diameter, which will make an 11 inch stone. I got another half, got it here. I cut a hole in the bottom from where I'll be putting the concrete. Before that, I will tape them together as well as I can, and then mix concrete, put it in, let it settle for a few days. Take the molds apart and let the stone rest for a few days, and then I'll be ready for you to use it. These balls cost around 10 euros here in Europe. I don't know about the American prices, but I guess they are around the same. A similar stone mold from Hybrid that you can buy on Rogue Fitness for the 11 inch, or I think it's 10.75, that will cost 71 euros for one mold. So with two of these for a total of 20 euros, you'll get the exact same size Atlas stone in the end. So let's get started. Remember to wear a glove if you have a sharp edge like I have on this end. Right now I'm just gonna add a few pieces of tape and then to fix it, and then I'll put some tape all the way around. We try to keep the edge as even as possible. I know the Hybrid stone mold will come with an outer edge that will go on top of each other, and the Slater stone molds will have an outer layer of one of them, and like that will fit on the inner layer on the other one, something like that. But I'll try to keep it as even as possible. I hope this will be enough. As I said, this is the very first time I'm making an Atlas stone. The next thing is to make some concrete, put it in here, and let it settle for a few days. I think it's important to put an extra layer of tape on the lower part of it, because concrete contains water and it will probably loosen up some of the tape. So another round, as I did here, and hopefully that will be enough. Let's try it out. Alright, so now I've mixed my concrete and ready to put it inside this mold. This might take a long time, I only have this shovel. When I got all that in, then I'll slap on the side with a rubber hammer to make the concrete settle all together and remove all the air bubbles, and then eventually I'll put some extra in. When working with the concrete, good idea to put on some gloves. It's really hard on the skin. Make sure to hammer on the side enough so that you can see the air bubble starting to come up here. If you don't do this, the air will stay inside the concrete and making it less strong, and you will also be able to see air bubbles on the outside of the concrete ball. So, I think this is as good as it gets, and then I'm not gonna move it around. I'm just gonna leave it out here in my shed, and I'm not gonna be out here for a few days anyway, so next time you'll see, it's in a few days, then we will take it out, and after that it's gonna rest a few days after that.
Alright, so my stone have been in the mold for almost a week, 6 days, and since it's not a really big stone, I think it's dry enough for now. Then I'll take it out of the mold and leave it out for a few days.
So, let's see how it looks. Just gonna cut open all the tape.
It took me a while to get the stone out of the mold. I actually had to cut up the mold itself because the stone was sticking to the sides. So I used an angle grinder for that. So a tip is to use some lubricant, some silicone oil, cover the inside of the mold with that. But nevertheless, I got the stone out, and as you can see, it's here.
So all the holes that you see on this part is air bubbles, which I was trying to slap out with my hammer. And as you can see, I cut it with my angle grinder, but this can be fixed. And this is the top. As you can see, there is a bulk up here. This, for this, you will have to grind it with a cup that can be mounted on an angle grinder for grinding concrete. Like this, and it just goes on the angle grinder instead of the cutting plate.
One thing that I find very interesting is that if you take a look at the bottom part, now all the air bubbles is out, which I did expect, but it's a completely different surface. And I know the bowls from IKEA was from two different countries, but they look the same. But this one, the bottom one, was made in or is made in Vietnam, and this one is made in China. I don't know what makes the difference, but these two halves are not does not have the same tick. I kind of like, you know, both surfaces, but I will fix the top part. I will grind this down, and then I will fill all the small holes. And before I fix it with some new concrete, I'll just use a similar mix. Then I will make sure the surface is properly wet. So I'll just take some cloth with a lot of water on and put that around and make sure everything is wet. And then I'll fix it with some new concrete.
That's it, guys. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button. Here's a few other videos that might find your interest. If you haven't already done so, please subscribe to my channel. See you soon.